people have the LDN and they're scared to take it. They have lots of questions. Mm-hmm. I always say, go back to your compounding pharmacy, ask yes. them your questions. You know, yes. they're the people that you should be working with and ask. They will check for you your other drugs that you're taking. I mean, I don't know how many weeks, months, or whatever that you learned about drug interactions, but that's far higher than a doctor would have done. You know, it's the pharmacist who deals with the drug interactions. And if you have questions, the person to ask is your compounding pharmacy, because they're the people that have done the training. They will yes. know your background and be able to answer your questions accurately. So Absolutely. That's always my answer to people is, you know, go back and ask, because compounding pharmacists, they're not scary people. They're not, you know, too busy to answer the questions. If you're a patient, they want to help their patients. So they're the people to speak to. So,
well, I really appreciate that, Linda, because that really is the premise of what we do every day is, yes, we compound medications, but we really are the drug experts. Pharmacists are in school for 5 to 6 years, specifically looking at medications. We are required to complete continuing education every single year to relicense. And most of us, especially in the compounding world, because it is a very specialized area of pharmacy, we don't go into compounding lightly, right? So by law, every pharmacy can compound, but that doesn't mean they should. Just like every physician shouldn't be a brain surgeon, right? I mean, maybe they can perform some surgery and stitch up your boo-boo on your finger, but that doesn't mean they should be doing brain surgery. I mean, that's a very specialized area of medicine, just like compounding. And compounding pharmacists, especially those that get together and chat and share information, we have a lot to provide patients. If you are curious enough to go to your provider and say, I really want to try low-dose naltrexone, but it just sits in the bottle and sits on your counter, it really doesn't do you any good. First of all, you spent your well-earned money on that. But if it sits in the bottle, it's not going to really help you. There's no evaporation or osmotic effect by sitting in the bottle. You gotta take it. If you've got questions, ask. Absolutely ask. Most compounding pharmacies have avenues that you can reach out either through text, by phone calls, by emails. So if you're thinking of a question and it's, 10:45 at night, usually you can still get a hold of your, get a hold of your compounding pharmacy and they'll get back to you as soon as they can. That way you're going to get your question out there and they're going to have time to perhaps research it and get back to you. So you can also pick up the phone and call. Email, it's all easy. Every website that I visited through a compounding pharmacy has a way that you can actually reach out and contact them. Send them a message. Most people even text back and forth nowadays, so give that a shot. But yes, please ask. That's what we're here for.